Hundreds of people packed the steps of the city county building here downtown just below that large terrible towel, many of them having their own terrible towels to pay tribute to a man who meant so much to this city. It was deafeningly silent. In a united show of respect for Myron Cope, Pittsburghers waved their terrible towels for the man who invented them. And a large towel hung in the arch of the city county building as Cope was honored by longtime friend and Steelers owner Dan Rooney.
This is a great tribute to Myron. Myron did so much for the Steelers, you know, it can't be put in words.
Local leaders, local celebrities, and a Cope family spokesperson told the crowd what Myron meant to the city.
And because of his legacy, the impact of Myron's life will be felt and his remarkable voice will be heard forever in the Steeler Nation. People that would move to Pittsburgh would say, who the heck is that guy that does Steeler games? And I would proudly say, that's Myron Cope!
And even through the heavy snow on a cold Friday afternoon, Pittsburghers showed Myron Cope the same dedication and respect he had given them his entire life.
He's gone, but he's always going to be with us. Every Steeler game, every year.
It's a sad day. Pittsburgh's lost its voice.
Very emotional right now. Very emotional. I'm going to miss him. I listen to him all the time.
Many Pittsburghers say because Myron Cope's funeral was so private, they really needed this in order to say goodbye to him as well. Downtown Pittsburgh, Marcy Cipriani, Channel 4 Action News.